with y'all, man. So this is a new vlog, y'all. We in a new space, y'all, as you can tell. You feel me? We in my Casa space, you feel me? What's good with y'all, man? This is Devani. We are in doing a YMDR vlog. You feel me? So I didn't get to do no vlog with y'all or show y'all just what was going down, you know, with my stuff or my situation, but now y'all know, you feel me? Now y'all know. Now y'all know what's up, and yeah, y'all be able to see that. So, but I'm going to get into something real fast that will get y'all in on some pointers on stuff. So let me return back to y'all. Peace out.
So we back at it again, and I just wanted to let y'all know, man, you know, YMDR, we definitely can get back to just doing some of that stuff in a sense and stuff like that. But this video, y'all, you know, like, I know it's like a vlog, but it's basically just a vlog to kind of explain to y'all, you know, just some different things that's been going down. You know, because, you know, over time, just different space and different stuff, you know, there's always been like some room for like different things to kind of transpire. And, you know, this is one of those different things, you know, this is one of those different seasons, you know, and just all types of different stuff like that. So I just wanted to bring y'all on this journey and let y'all see it for yourself, you know, as we continue. So what I think that I wanted to talk to y'all about in specifics from what I started was is what y'all don't know is the YMDR domain obviously has been updated. You know, I have updated the YMDR domain, and that mug last for the next year, which would be 2021, you know, type stuff like that. So yeah, you know, that's in a sense, like, that's exciting, you know, because of the fact that, you know, doing YMDR was a very hard kind of thing, you know, kind of transpiring between different stuff, because, you know, trying to create things in your own, in somebody else's space is a little difficult, especially with, you know, all the stress and all the other different things. But when you got your own space, it's a little more better. You know how to create what you want to create without, you know, any hassle. But overall, you know, that's the reason why, you know, in this sort of journey, I wanted to kind of take y'all on and tell y'all, you know, that domain being what it is, you know, like, this video is kind of like an introduction to try to just almost try to ask people, you know, what do you people think of YMDR, and what do, you know, is it a useful thing to you, you know, like, as well, you know, just something to kind of bring to the table and ask, you know, the people so they can understand, you know. And I think the main reason, you know, this is just asked and this is just thought about is because, you know, in the midst of our journeys, you know, in creating, you know, the things that we create, you know, we don't always have a lot of people, you know, to create these things with. Some of these things are usually done with just myself, as an artist, you know, and kind of somebody who does all the rest of the other things, you know, the editing that is done by me. You know, if I do street performances, I have the equipment that's done by me. You know, if I do other different things, you know, that stuff is pretty much done by me. You know, like, I'm usually the one who's doing it. So I mean, it's just a way for me to almost try to ask and see, you know, if YMDR moves forward into the next step of 2021, you know, will people grasp the understanding of what YMDR is? You know, will people see what it actually is conveying, you know, through the messages that it has been conveying over the years, you know, yes, you know, like, I will admit, you know, a lot of different things kind of stuck in the middle and kind of struck into why I wasn't able to do a lot of the things that I wanted to do. With a little bit of that was, like, you know, living with my moms, that was a little bit of a hardship because there were convictions and things that she believed that was a little hard for her to understand, while as to myself, you know, I understood what I understood and she understood what she understood. And I think it was, the reason it was very hard was because it seemed like, you know, my belief system in faith and in Christianity and what that was very much clashing with her belief system, which was of the Hebrew Israelites. And if you don't know what the Hebrew Israelites are, you know, y'all people probably know that the Hebrew Israelites usually are these people who have a very strict aspect on the racial, you know, racial color of your skin, you know, opposed to you being black. And they have very variations of different types. You know, there's different types of camps. You know, there's some that are very negatory towards if you're not able to believe the same way as them and you are of black descent, like they think you're ignorant because you don't choose to believe the same way that they do. And then there's ones where, like, you know, they can see that you have a different belief system and they will still try to force it on you regardless. And so, you know, I think, like, for myself, you know, I was just in a very much of a daze of trying to kind of fight through that sort of odds. You know, I was trying to kind of fight through the essences of trying to know, like, what all or why all was it able for me to do the things that I was able to do? Like, how can I do these things and not get into any issues, you know, the way that I was in, you know, and stuff like that. So it's like, you know, what's being brought to the table now and what you see in it now is that it brings forth that, you know, I'm not around, you know, my mom anymore. Like, this crib that I'm in is literally my crib, you know. So I mean, like, I don't have any constructs of having to, you know, duke out what I understand and what I believe. I can just truly believe the things that I want to believe about God and let that be that. You feel me? Because, and that's, you know, that's good for me. You know, I value that and I appreciate it the way that it is supposed to be, you know, in a sense, you know. So, but I, you know, I think about just how will YMDR excel from here, you feel me? Because people, you know, don't know, like, since that I have this own crib as my own crib, you know, I will be able to do vlogs, you know, and other different things. And I'll be able to have to do, you know, little side hustles. And those side hustles will be like what I already do for YMDR. You know, that'll be, you know, doing pictures or photography or this or that or that or this. And that will consist of, if, you know, people will gravitate to that. You know, they will see, you know, well, what is he doing here? What is he doing there? What is he doing here? You know, it will kind of determine on the grasping of, you know, there's people sometimes, you know, there was a guy I think I ran into and he, you know, was wondering why I didn't make YMDR legit yet. And I mean, the reason why I didn't was because, you know, YMDR needs people, you know, like, this is just something that is, you know, a must, is that YMDR needs people. And, you know, there was a time where I literally opened up about YMDR needing people. You know, I talked about it. I said, hey, man, you know, I'm going to try to go to all these different churches and try to ask if these people of God knows any other people who are in their church or congregation that are talented believers or talented people of God. And they just want to kind of build on the aspect of something that would be helpful to, you know, the artist scene in Indianapolis. Because what we don't even know is that the artist scene in Indianapolis, some of them don't know the aspect of what a believer is. You know, some of them don't know the idea of what Christians are. You know, they just think that technically, you know, a Christian is just what they have been told over here or told over there. And so YMDR was just a way for Christians to try to get out of their comfort zone and allow them to see different points of view in a way where it puts their faith in contact with somebody who is not necessarily of itself, you know, to some people would seem kind of crazy. That in itself to some people seem kind of this, would seem kind of that, you know, like some people just think, why do we need a movement called YMDR to do that? And it's like, well, because YMDR, you know, I think the reason I even created it to do that was because I felt that a believer can do these things without YMDR. They can. But I was doing it the way that I was doing it because I was trying to grasp a sense of community in us doing it. But it would be something that would be not in the constructs of the church. You know, it wouldn't be connected to the church. YMDR isn't like a, it's not a nonprofit organization. It's kind of like a, it's a movement that you can invest money into, but at the same time, it's something that can be used to glorify God and build community and build relationships that grasp into unity, you know, with other people. And so what I have felt in the midst of creating it is that, are there believers out here who are willing to be in community with another believer? You know, are there believers out here who are willing to understand the perspective from another believer? Are we willing to even come together to build, you know, something that can be useful for everyone to understand opposed to just what people already know? In this, you know, like I just felt and determined a determination to build this in Indianapolis, and I felt the determination to just say that I was gonna build it even if nobody built it with me, you know. And that determination kind of went, you know, the way that it went, even when I didn't have any church friends to kind of do it with, you know, like I still just did it regardless. And so what I found in doing that was that I was, yes, the one who usually was able to do the things that I was able to do. Another guy who was able to do it was Warren Hesley, you know, and he was one that kind of understood this perspective as well. You know, he understood the belief of being a person of God, you know, but I, you know, my grasping of what I wanted believers who knew, who had talents and abilities in the churches, I was wanting them to advance that talent and ability and not just be in one little space. Because that's the thing about being a Christian, is you can bring your faith anywhere you go towards any person, and that can help them to grasp the understanding of a believer. You feel me? And that's something that most people have not done, you know, but it can be done. You feel me? Like, so it's not a thing that can't be done. You know, it can be done. But yeah, like I just feel like that was what the mission of YMDR was, you know. Even when I did it in 2020, I still just feel like, again, this was a shocker situation. I didn't know that this would build into what it did, because it's like God kind of built this whole structure of how it became. He embodied the idea that I would be in a circumstance where things would change for me, because I remember that I prayed, you know, to God about the situation of me being in the issues with my mom. And so, I mean, I feel like this is also him kind of like responding to the idea of helping in the process of it. And I also think it's just an idea and a way for me to kind of know, you know, if I need to continue to keep doing YMDR, you know, if I need to balance out the idea of what it's actually worth, you know, or do I just sell the domain and just say, like, I don't even need to do it anymore, you know, like, that's, you know, like, that's what I openly think, like, this will bring the door to open into, is, you know, if YMDR is something that is worth doing to help other people, then I will continue to do that. But if it's not, you know, like, I need to see what, you know, it is that God has for me to do in the midst of that. You know, so that's why I felt like, you know, just in creating this and kind of making this video is just kind of like a way to kind of say, you know, do people want more of YMDR? You know, do they want more of what it grasps? You know, do they understand why it is what it is? You know, I know that I've been on my YouTube page and I haven't been able to really get down to the grimy of putting all the things that I could be putting on my, you know, my YouTube page and growing my fan base and all that stuff. Like, I know I haven't even gotten into the idea of the YouTube ads. I know I haven't gotten into any of those things entirely yet because of the fact that marketing is one hell of a thing. You have to learn how to do that stuff first and then escalate it to the... But yeah, you know, I'm just right now in this season, you know, I'm just trying to kind of bring an idea just to the forefront if anyone is taking, you know, these things into consideration. You know, do I continue doing this thing that God created me to do? And, you know, at the end of the day, you know, like, there are some things that I can't go away from anyway. There are a lot of things that when it comes to YMDR, like, I can't fully push myself away from because I value them. You know, so it doesn't make sense to just push myself away from it, you know, but I just think in the midst of it too, you know, like, if it was built for community and then there's not many believers who feel the need to be in community, that's the hard part that kind of stabs in, is do believers feel that we need community? Do we feel that when it comes to the talents and abilities that we have, do we feel that we can use that as an impact to help these other people out here who don't know anything about believers? And can we use that to where they can actually learn what believers are? Because, and what that can open a door to, you know, in a sense, from what I already know and what I've already seen from a bro kind of telling me, you know, believers have dirt. Some of them have some dirt. Some of them have some things they don't really show people until one kind of sees it the way that they see it, and then they kind of, you know, express it to somebody else, and then when they do, you know, they see that this person is really in a bad season of his faith, you know. So I mean, of course there are times where these things kind of happen and we see them the way we see it. Like, you know, where do we draw an idea of bringing believers together to build community and relationship, and where do we build an idea that we can connect with each other in a way because we have the talents and abilities that we have just like anybody else, but we, you know, where's just the community in that? And so, you know, yeah, y'all, like, ultimately, you know, like, that's why, you know, I wanted to kind of create this video and kind of just tell y'all, these are just things that are legitimately on my heart, you know, like, these aren't things that I'm trying to write down or copy. That's why I didn't write anything to this whole thing. Like, I kind of just freestyled it and did it how I needed to do it because I just felt like, you know, this is a genuine hard question. You know, if you value community as a person of God, you know, are you willing to step in that community with another person of God? You know, and even if you're not a person of God, but you just value the community of things that people can do, you know, are you willing to go out on a limb and be in something that will actually, you know, value the things that you do, you know, as a person? And so, you know, in a sense, you know, y'all, you know, that's what I hope I can leave with people about this whole idea or experience, and I hope it can make some sort of impact. I'm not saying that it will. God is the one who truly knows what will happen with this, and we'll see as time progresses. So I hope you have a wonderful day, man. I hope y'all keep it chill on the YMDR page, and know that we out here, and I'll check with y'all next time.